Good morning, 9th class. Today we are going to start our second lesson, that is Sound of Music. Sound of Music, Part 1, Evelyn Glennie listens to the sound without hearing it. Sound of Music is a story of a girl, Evelyn, who was quite deaf. She cannot listen anything, but she feels music. She cannot listen the music, but she feels music. So this is the story of the girl, that how much success she got in the field of music. So I am here to tell you the main points today. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Her mother noticed it when the 8-year old was waiting to play the piano and did not move when her mother was called out. When mother called out her name, she was not able to listen. The loss of hearing was gradual, slowly and gradually it happened, and mother came to know all these things when she was 8 years old and she was to play the piano. She did not move because mother was calling her and she did not pay any notice to her. So at that time mother came to know that she is not able to listen. Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from the teachers and friends for quite a while. She tried to hide all these things. She tried to hide that she cannot hear. She tried to hide the things from the teachers and friends for quite a while. But by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated. But at the age of 11, everybody came to know that she was not able to listen properly. When she was taken to a specialist, it was discovered that her hearing was severely impaired due to the gradual nerve damage. And when she was taken to the doctor, all came to know that it is due to the gradual nerve damage. Means the nerves are there in her ear and they have got damaged. Everything looked black, but Evelyn did not give up. Means there was no hope. All were in despair, but Evelyn did not give up. She didn't give up. She was brave. She was determined to pursue her interest in music. She did not give up. She keep on learning music. Her percussionist, Ron Forbes, noticed her potential and trained her to feel the notes of drums. Ron Forbes was her piano teacher, who helped her to learn the music and helped and trained to feel her the notes, not to listen. He taught her how to feel the music. He asked her not to listen through her ears, but sense the vibration some other way. So Ron also taught her to feel the music from different parts of her body. Evelyn could feel the higher drum from the waist up and the lower one from the waist down. So she was able to feel the music high when very high pitch was there from the upper part from the waist, and when the low pitch was there from the down part from the waist. Soon with practice she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. And slowly and gradually with the practice, she was able to listen the music with her. She was able to sense the music with her different body parts. She had learned to open her mind and body to sound and vibration. Now she has learned that how she can feel the music. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the academy. So she gave the audition, and in the audition Royal Academy of Music, she scored the highest marks. She got the highest marks. At the end of the 3 years course, she had won of the most top awards, and though she was very hardworking, so with the training of 3 years, with the course of 3 years, she won the most of the top awards. She effortlessly gives interviews by watching not just the lips but the whole face, especially the eyes. She can speak flawlessly because she could hear till the age of 11. Up to the age of 11, she was able to listen, therefore she could understand with the help of the whole face, and she was able to speak also. Music, according to her, pours it through every part of her body. It tingles in the skin, her cheekbones, and even in her hair. So she is told that music enters in her body through every part, not from the ears but all parts of the body. When she plays the xylophone, she can sense the sound passing through her fingertips. Xylophone is an instrument of music, and when she plays xylophone, she could able to listen all the music through her fingertips. By leaning against the drum, she can feel the renaissance flowing into her body, and when she stand against the drum, she feel all the vibration in her body. On a wooden platform, she remove her shoes so that the vibration pass through her and bare feet and up her legs. And on the wooden floor, she stand barefooted, means without wearing the slippers, and she feel the music through her feet. In 1994, she was presented with the Royal Philanthropic Society prestigious Solicit of the Year Award. She got this award in 1994. Apart from regular concerts, she gives free concert in prisons and hospital. She also gives high priority to classes for young musicians. She gave free shows in prisons and hospitals, and also for the young musicians for free classes. Evelyn has demonstrated that percussion can be very moving. She got right to the top, the world most sought percussionist, with mastery of some thousand instruments and hectic international schedule. She got right to the top of the world most sought after percussionist, with a mastery of some thousand instruments and hectic international schedule. She is a shining inspiration for those who are handicapped, because it makes them feel, if she can do, we can. So in the last, we can say that she is an inspiration for all those who think that we cannot do anything, those who are handicapped people. But now they think, if Evelyn can do everything, that why not we? We can do this. So this is the main point of the lesson, and I will send you the lesson, you read it.